Hello everybody, welcome back with some more Kingdom Hearts, Chain of Memories. Today we're going through Halloween Town again. I think I'm getting kind of tired of saying the same intro over and over again. I'm just running out of breath too, as well. Of course, you know, just, we need to think of something new, right? You know, something new and innovative. You know what I'm saying? Something just that rolls right off the tongue. Maybe I should start doing that for my next Let's Play, which I still have no idea what's going to be yet. But I have one in mind that I would like to do. What room do I need to go to next? I believe I need to go to this room, probably. So we go right, up, and then right. Right? Correct, Mundo? Maybe, possibly? I don't even know yet. Okay, yeah, so we go up this way. I think so. Well, no, if we go up, that's going to lead me to... Yeah, because... Wait, what? Don't know. What's that room then? Has not been opened yet. Okay. Neither has that one. That one was the Key of Beginnings. I assume that that one here is going to be the non... Yeah. And that last one over there is probably the Conqueror's Room. Wait, I can't... No, I think I can only go up in this room. I don't think I can go right. But then... Yeah, because you can't go... Yeah, that's right. Duh. So I guess it doesn't really matter, really, to be honest. Just use another comm bounty again, because I have plenty of these. Might as well try to get my sights done as quickly as possible. In case there might be a good sight that comes up, I don't know. It's possible, folks. Typically in Halloween Town, I do the same thing here anyway. Oh my shit. That's not actually too shabby. Hang on, let's go find these fours. We need what? We got a nine, so that's a definite put in there right now kind of situation. You know what? No, take that one out. Yeah, because fuck premiums. Yeah, we got plenty of room. Okay, sweet. Nice. Let's hope we get some more cards out of this, though. That'd be nice. Let's see. Nothing yet? I haven't seen anything yet. Oh, hey! It's just an ether. Okay, great. Ether! And nothing there. And nothing there. And looks like it's going to be a kingdom key, unfortunately, a four. So it's practically almost kind of worthless at this point. Sort of. I mean, yeah, it can, you know... negate other cards and such, but let's see. Let's do Teeming Darkness just because we haven't done this one for a while, and you know, might as well get a little bit of experience in before I have to leave Halloween Town, which I am currently afraid of, because I think after the first set of world cards we fought Axel, and then after the second set, spoiler alert, we're probably gonna end up fight Larxene, and that's what I'm afraid of. I'm terrified of fighting her, just because my first experience with this game was not very good because I had to fight her. She is death-defying. She's terrifying. She really is. She's quick. That's her thing. That's her type of deal. Like, not just her cards in general, but just her in general. Just as a fact. She is fucking retardedly fast. Now, the thing about 2, though, that I like the most, it's not really a spoiler, but it's more of just like saying what's going to happen. They have these things called data rematches. It's at the end of the game. Pretty much, what's that end game? Where you can basically fight all 13 organization members again. Which is awesome. I love that idea. Like, if you had fun fighting the first time, you know, either via Kingdom Hearts 2 or not, then, you know, you can fight them in like a legit format. And it's just, you guys will see it when we get there. Now, am I going to be doing Final Mix? More likely, yes. Which I think that might be a Final Mix situation only. I don't know. I recently bought Kingdom Hearts 2 Vanilla. This was like a month or two ago? Maybe? Might have been before Christmas. I think it was after Christmas. Must have been January, at least. January or February, sometime in there, I bought Kingdom Hearts 2, the Vanilla one. And I've noticed so many different changes. It's ridiculous. Some things are harder, some things are easier. So I'm just going to stick with Final Mix, just because that's the one I'm sure they want us to play. And I'll be playing the HD version, of course, straight off the PlayStation 3, so there's that. Well, obviously, I'm going to have to play that off the PlayStation 3, because... Well, I think the only way to get Final Mix, like PS... Or... I think it might have been PS2. Because of, you know, like, Japanese stuff. I think Japan got Final Mix first. Than we did. Before we did, then I think we get... Unless... You know, I have no idea. I really don't know anything about Final Mix. I don't know how it worked out. I don't know if it was a PS2 thing for Japan or not. I don't know if we got it here or not, because we have it here now, because we have the HD remixes that allow you, or the collections you can call them, that allow you to play, you know, basically every kind of Final Mix. Now, Birth by Sleep, I think, might be a final mix as well. Or, no, I think it's just a regular, I think it's just the same way it was before. Which was just a PSP title, which, you know how PSPs were back then, so they were, you know, they did the same thing with God of War, Chained Olympus. They left it the same way, you know, naturally, just because, why change something? You know, it's basically in the same generation as PS3, so it's practically the same thing, almost. Yeah, they're handhelds, but still. That's how I see it, at least. I'm sure most people don't see it the same way I do, but I'm different. At least I try to be. I want to get that experience over there before it's too late. And bam. Okay, we got it all. Great. Awesome. Now, the thing is, I don't think they disappear when they're... Like, once the thing is finished, I'm sure they don't disappear. That would be completely retarded. They disappeared while they're trying to teleport to you. That would just be dumb. I think so. Okay, let's waste the gargoyle real fast. Take out the shadow. And we're done. Okay, sweet. And we got a lot of nice cards from it, too. I love seeing all this stuff fly into me. It's so cathartic. It really is. Okay, yeah, watch out for that guillotine there. I think that can do damage. Maybe. We'll find out. Yeah, Halloween Town's a very dangerous place to be. Oddly enough. You know, like, it's supposed to be a place of comfort, right? Like, you know, you just scare people and that's it. Well, I wouldn't really call that necessarily comforting, but hey, you know. Well, Halloween Town is a very nice place to be at. Hell, I'd love to visit the place, to be honest. It seems like a really nice place to go. You know, you got all these really nice, cool people there, too. And of course you have fucking... What's their nuts? Forgot the kids' names. Shit. Larry, Moe, and Curly. Yeah, something like that. Well, basically, the little bastards, you know, they run around and cause mischief. Lock, Shock, and Barrel. That's what their name was. Okay. I knew it all along. I was just, you know, I was just trying to pretend I didn't know so I can get some comments going. I heard you guys, you know, already typing in the comment section. I knew somebody was. So I had to, you know. I guess I stopped you. I would have felt bad if you would have commented and already said it. That would have been a waste of time. You know, some people do waste their time sometimes with that. Like, I've had comments, especially on my second channel and just other, like, Let's Plays of mine, where people will comment something kind of stupid. Like, a remark that's, you know, pretty much obvious. It's like, yes, I know. Or I'm sure the audience knows already. I don't know, but, you know, as a YouTuber, you're going to get that anyway. So, like, if you guys start doing your own YouTube stuff... You'll see what I'm talking about when you get to that point. If you guys want to do your own stuff. Which, a lot of the people that watch me, there's a few people out there that I have seen do stuff on their own, like Let's Plays. And they're good, you know, all my subscribers so far have been really, really good people. Even if they don't do their own content, you know, most of you guys don't, usually, like, when somebody subscribes to me, sometimes I tend to check to see if they have content on their own, just so I can kind of support back, you know? That's the way I see it as, or just like, hey, you know, you're supporting me, might as well support you. But lots of people that watch me don't do that. So it might sound creepy, and to me it sounds like a creepy thing to do, but I don't mean to be like that. It's just like, hey, you guys got content, you know? Hey, that's cool, sweet. Now we can join together. I'm just not one for doing collabs very much, it really depends, honestly. Like, to me, a collab has to come with somebody that I either, like, really know or really, familiar with, like, just in general, like, in person, you know, or just somehow, like, there's some behind-the-scenes thing going on, you know, like, talking or whatever, and it's like, you know, hey, I do my own content, like, you know, I don't really need to have a collab, but it would be cool to meet you, you know, talk to you. We just do like a random video or something like that. I don't know. I just, like, when it comes to like playing on like PlayStation or something with other like random strangers, it just turns me away. Just turns me off a little bit. It's like, I just don't feel comfortable. And it's not because like, you know, my subs are bad people. They're not. I'm sure they're not. Because why would they be subbed to me, right? Of course, you know. You guys are looking out for me, which makes you a nice person in general. And I love you for that. But the thing is, like, I just don't feel... I'm very, I guess... I hate to say it, but I'm pretty much kind of in an awkward position sometimes when I do meet new people. It just makes me feel kind of uncomfortable, especially, like, not if they're not in real life. Which I've met people online before, I've talked to people online before, especially, like, on Call of Duty and such. But even then, like, I still feel like I'm in a predicament of being uncomfortable. And that's my thing, too. It's not because the person's bad or awkward. It's just because I'm awkward, I guess. I just am socially awkward. I have a hard time trying to attach to people, I guess. And I don't know where it stems from. I think it's just because my family in general. Not because of what they do, but just because they don't do anything with anybody. 6, 7, and 8 would be good enough. 3 attack cards of different types. Oh, fuck. So it has to be... Right, total value 20 to 23. Okay, gotcha. So we need to find a 6 and a 7 and a 3. That will take some doing. Like, that's going to take some looking around to figure that out. I don't know if the order matters. So a 7, a 6, instead of 3? This work? No, I need a 3, that's right. Or was it a 3? I have no idea. Might have been a 5, for all I know. I'll have to look again, but it's Sonic Blade, pretty much. Let's see. Oh, you broke my fucking card. Aren't you cute? And there goes Goofy, because I just realized he's a 0. Yeah, that's very damaging. That hurts a lot. Fuck you, Mr. White Knight, and fuck you, Mr. Gargoyle. Because you guys decided to wreck all of my cards, pretty much, that I had, and stuck. You know, the thing is, I could use Jafar, honestly. Yeah, why not? Thing is, with special cards, what happens with those... Yeah, like, look at this shit. Well, I'm on 8s and such. They're not going to do much to me when I'm on 8. I'll show you guys what happens when I use, like, 5s and 3s. Like, I use it... Well, it shouldn't have broken. Huh. Weird. Maybe, like, whenever I use it... Yeah, it's weird. It's not supposed to be breaking. I don't get why. That's... It's supposed to... I don't know. It's better with Riku, I personally think. I think Riku has a better advantage with it because his cards are set up to a different way than mine. Like, you'll see when we get there... It's just, I'm confused of how to use Jafar exactly. I don't know how to use him particularly very well either. Okay, let's see here. Do I have the truth key? Or no, we're heading to the, yeah, that's right, we're heading to one right now. No, I'll go back, I want to see my status. Sonic Blade requires what? Can I see what it requires? 6, 7, and 8. Okay, then why am I an idiot? It's a 6, 7, why did I think 3? Where the hell did that come from? Honestly, I have no clue. I have no clue where the hell that came from. I'll show you guys Sonic Blade. Let's see. Yeah, here's a Lady Luck. Here's a 3 Wishes. And a... Oh, another... I was using another Lady Luck. That's why. Okay, how about this? 6. Okay, that's 3 Wishes. Okay, now take that back. 6. Lady Luck. 7. And the 8 will be Olympia. Sonic Blade. There we go. But it could be, 21 to 23, I think. Sonic Blade is retarded. Especially, like, in the original game. It's... By that, I mean, like, it's retardedly good. It is devastating, especially... Oh my god, wait till we get to 2. Now, Final Mix adds it as a limit form, pretty much, which is kind of like a callback to, you know, Kingdom Hearts 1, but it is amazing in Kingdom Hearts 2. It's ridiculous how good it is. Like I said, don't worry, guys. We'll get there sometime. I mean, it might be next year. Might be the end of this year. Who knows? I don't want to say it just yet. I want to get most of the stuff in my lineup finished this year. And maybe, you know, in the beginning of next year, if need be. But, yeah. Thing is, also with special cards, you have to activate them every single time you do a battle. So, they're not going to stay active for, like, the entirety of the game. Which I kind of wish they did. You know, I kind of wish they just specially just activate, you know, a small little activation. It's like... They wouldn't hinder, you know, anything. They wouldn't, like, be particularly too powerful, but that, to me, would make it a little easier. But then again, you know, this is fine, too. Guess we're stuck with what we have, right? Okay. And so many gargoyles right now. This is getting out of hand, folks. Just gonna blow these guys out of proportion. They could probably break my fort. Yeah. So basically, Dumbo at this point has become obsolete. Because now that the further we go down the rabbit hole, the harder it's going to get to want to be able to play him. Yeah, because they're going to fuck me over. Ice sucks, Donald. I don't know why you haven't realized that yet. You need to jump, boy. That's your problem. You don't jump. Okay. And, wow, that was a nice hit, actually. What'd I get? A save point again? Hey, you know, the more the merrier. I'll take them. They're nice to have. We don't need them, but I'll take it. Well, I definitely, for some reason, needed it earlier, apparently. Okay, that's odd. Wait, can I, hold on, stop. Like, it's weird, like, I have a lock-on thing for it, too. but I can't do anything with it. Huh. Strange. All right, let's go ahead and pop this bad boy in a 6. Fuck me. And a 7. Fuck me. What the devil? The bloody hell? All right, there we go. I think we got them all. And there we go. All right, sweet. So now let's go ahead and finish this in probably like 2 or so videos. 3? Maybe? Well, the end of one and then a whole episode last time, and now this will hopefully be like half. Okay, I'm just going to say this now. Earlier, I honestly thought that Lock, Shock, and Barrel were the ones that took the potion. No, it literally was Sally, which makes sense because she's worried about Jack's safety, and I understand why. She tends to do that a lot. Okay, so right. Gotcha. So we need to go this way. No, that's up. I'm retarded. No, Alex. Bottom right. Not upper right. Okay, let's do this legit this time. I'm kind of confused on which door's what. This will take me that way. Okay, good. Good, good, good. Now, here's the thing. Now we're going to go take down Oogie Boogie. So, get ready for that. That's a treasure, I believe. And keep heading this way and take a down direction. And there we go. We got to the Key of Truth. Yep, another door's here. There's a lot of common bounties, though, which I could, you know, easily put in more. Or I could put in the Moogle Room. But I don't really feel like that would be necessary. So, I think we got some good cards. I might just switch out to Far just because I'm not using it very often. And really, it's just kind of a hindrance at this point. Like, it's a good card, it's just... I can't seem to... What the fuck did it... Oh, duh. Like, it doesn't really do me any good. Another 7 of that, though. I could put one of those in. Let's see. Let's put in... Could do another potion. Let's take a Dumbo, because fuck Dumbo. Fire is good. Okay, let's switch these up, because something is... a miss. You know, like, something's just not right with these. Okay. Let's put in that there. And let's put in nice little fire. Put that one here and put an ice in as well. So that way we can kind of, like, combo into them a little bit, you know? We can put in... Could do an ether. I can show you guys what ether does. If you guys... That... Actually, that... Because cure is magic cards. So, that could actually come in hand. That works. Alright, sweet. Okay. We don't really need all that stuff, but hey, I'll take it. Might as well try it out, you know? And let's see here. We need a 3 or below, obviously, so it'd be a 1. That's a good one. We need 30 greens. So, just pile them up. And, you know, just use all these ones that you got. Use all the big ones, I guess. Got plenty of 7s, 6s, and bam, there we go. Alright, sweet. And pop goes a weasel. Key to Truth, here we go, and then boss fight. More than likely, and then Conqueror's Respite. Or Respite, what do you want to call it? Something like that. Okay, so this is Oogie Boogie, and basically his fight does kind of work the same way it did sort of in the original game, but with a bit of a different change here. In the original game, it was more or less of a, like, roulette kind of deal, but this time it's like more of like a dice throw kind of thing. I guess if you break his card, you can... Basically, what you have to do is break his card, find the correct dice. He has specific kind of dice that are going to be really obnoxious. As you can tell right there, for a split second, there were some ones that looked like they were about to explode. So you got to kind of be careful of that there. And pretty much once you get him... Like, once you get the Mickey gimmick card, that's when you can go ahead and break down the fence and give him a nice little pounding, which seems to me like we got quite a bit of health taken off on him. Jump away from that, because I think you can take damage. It looked like it did for a second. Looks like we got a nice jack card going on here, so now we're going to break it with a 5. My bad, it was a... Fuck it. Well, I broke that. That wasn't exactly what I had in mind to do, but hey. I'm just reload. Fuck that. There's just... Yeah, now I gotta do with gargoyles. This is unfortunate. Wait, he broke me the 0. Oh, damn. And it didn't seem like the freaking, you know, recoil on that was too good. Like, you know, the freaking pumpkin said. Unfortunately, it looks like I'm not getting any, like, good, stuff from that. When I say good stuff, I mean, it looks like, to me, I'm not getting anything, how do you put it? Crap. I don't know what I was gonna say. Well, okay, let's just say this right now. Basically, this is just a crapshoot at this point. You pretty much just have to weigh him down. Hopefully get some, try to keep some 7s so you can at least card break him. Like, try not to waste those too much. And just, you know, again, card break him a lot and then finally just finish him off. So, should be easy enough, I would think, at least. Looks like I almost got him down with 1 health left and bam, right before he even did anything. And that's a nice pose right there, too. That could possibly be, like... thumbnail potential at that point, but yeah, nah, maybe we might find something better. Well, there we go. That's Oogie Boogie in a nutshell. Really easy fight, I think so. Fun fight, but pretty easy. Same thing with Kingdom Hearts 1 and, well, I should say 2. We do put up with him later, but he's fun either, regardless. The thing is, Jack is really a good-hearted person, and I like Jack as a character. The other thing is, too, about Halloween Town, well, just Nightmare Before Christmas in general, is I want to play Oogie's Revenge. I recently found out about it, you know, through, like, watching SGB and such, like, Elliot was talking about it. And it's, like, basically, I did look it up, and, like, Katakaris' sister actually did a video on it herself. Talking about the game, and it's basically like a Devil May Cry. It was made by Capcom too, which is crazy, but it kind of acts like Devil May Cry in a way, and it's a really cool looking game. You guys gotta check it out. Oogie's Revenge. It's like Nightmare Before Christmas, Oogie's Revenge, or something like that. I think I have good enough sets of cards. I would say I feel like I do. I can easily switch out, you know, stronger stuff, but I don't feel like that's really necessary. I think we're good to go. Alright, let's go ahead and save the game. Actually, no. Before we do that, if anybody wants to leave now, go ahead and leave, and I will see you guys in the next episode. But for the rest of you that want to stay, let's get into the journal entries, shall we? We don't have the story fully completed yet because we haven't left the world, but hey, that's okay. Seems to be no cards there. Enemy cards. I thought there was like an easy way to get to this. Oogie Boogie. Regen. Gradually restores HP. HP returns more quickly when low. Limits of 10 uses. That could be useful, actually. That makes sense to me. At least I understand how to do it. Well, I guess that's it. So, without further ado, folks, I do hope that you all... Wrong one. Wrong save. I just want to make sure. I want to save it on 3 just, you know, later. Just to be on the safe side. Or if everything went well, that is. So... I will see you guys when we get back for some more Chain of Memories. I might be done for the night, but I will probably more likely start back up tomorrow when I get the chance. I'm going to be live streaming with my friend sometime. I don't know yet, so he's going to be doing a live stream of Kingdom Hearts 1. I might just upload a quick video telling you guys I'll be streaming with him. Like, once we get everything set up and yada yada yada. So, I'm going to go on to something else. I might record some hardcore and stuff. Don't know yet. But I will leave you guys hanging for the next one once we get out of, you know, Halloween Town pretty much for good. Not only that, but I think we have to take on Larkseed next, so I'm a little frightened. Maybe. It makes sense. We're on Halloween Town. I should be frightened of Larkseed. Alright, folks. Take care, everybody.